In the next decade or so, 60% of North America's job force will disappear. Now that is shocking. The question then becomes is, how can you protect your future? How can you protect your kids' future? So let's first investigate this job force. What is disappearing? Out of the 60% of jobs disappearing, majority of these jobs in general are robotic jobs. They are aggregate and apply, meaning the individual in this job is doing data research. That's the first step. So they gather data. The second step is with that data, they now apply that data to a procedure. That is aggregate and apply. If you think about this, any robot can do that. Any software can do that. And you see it every single day. You see it. You know, more and more jobs are being replaced. Just the other day, I was reading TechCrunch or one of these like big media websites, and I saw McDonald's has hologram cashiers in Hong Kong. Hologram cashiers. Okay? Think about that for a second. Hologram cashiers. So what can you do to protect yourself and your kids' future? You gotta be educated. Not being educated, but being educated, if you get my drift. There's a two big difference right there. You gotta look at the trends. You can't be passive in life. You can't just say, oh, the government's gonna help me or the school system's gonna help me. No, you have to be aggressive. Not passive, but aggressive. You gotta push yourself. You gotta go out there and figure out what's going on. They ask Abraham Lincoln, Abraham Lincoln, how are you so good at predicting the future? It's like, I don't predict the future, I make my future. Successful people go out there and they forge their own path. They read, they research, they get mentored, they educate themselves on a daily basis. They understand the trends, what's happening on a global economic scale. So, let's go deeper into that 60%. If we're talking about replacement, that means new industries are being born. Robotics is gonna be huge. That's gonna be a $1 trillion industry. So there's a perfect example for you. Maybe you can get into robotics. Maybe you can learn programming. I always tell everybody, if you want your kids to have a brighter future, teach them programming. Whether that is front-end programming, back-end programming, blockchain programming, whatever types of programming, they all lead down the same rabbit hole. If you learn one, you learn many. Learn programming. Forget English or Mandarin language, so verbal language. It's all about the mathematical heuristic language that's gonna be the future. So programming. Number two, hardware. So if we're talking about robotics, obviously we need to develop these robots. That equals industries. So get into robotics. Now with robots become security. I just finished reading Alex Ross's book, Industries of the Future, and he talks about securities. This is gonna be a $1 trillion industry. That's why I'm a big fan of blockchain coming up. Not Bitcoin or anything, but blockchain from transfer of information from point A to point B. So maybe you can get into securities. What I mean by securities is software securities, hardware securities, securities in general. People always need to be secure. Information needs to be secure. Programs need to be secured. Robots as personal property need to be secured. Next industry that's gonna be disrupted is medicine. Huge disruption going on over there. Most of these big venture capitalist firms, including Sequoia, they are doubling down on genomics. So gene science, maybe you can get into that. This is where sometimes post-secondary school comes in handy, but this is specific, not general. You're not going to get a Bachelor of Arts or just even Bachelor of Science. You are progressing your field. So you're learning maybe, you know, molecular biology, or you're learning, for example, I don't know, maybe get your PhD in some genetic manipulation, etc. So it's very, you know, specific and just for that field. And you know for a fact that you're gonna be focusing on that and you become a specialist at that. And we always need health and genomics. There's a fine mixture of industries over there, because with genomics you have biotech, you have robotics, you have more into, you know, B2B play and also B2C play. Okay, now let's look around us. What are some immediate industries that you and I are gonna be affected within the first 5 years or the next 5 years? I was just with a councilman over here in Toronto. We're talking about plans for the new automated self-driving cars. Within 5 years, Toronto will have self-driving cars. So what does that mean? All these taxi drivers complaining, see you later. Even the Uber drivers, see you later. So what's gonna happen? Well, trucking industry, goodbye. So what do you do then with all these people that don't have a job anymore. You don't have a job, you're a trucker. How many truckers are there in North America? Hundreds of thousands? Maybe there's 2 million truckers in North America. What do you do with 2 million truckers? Well, A, let's look at what they do currently in their job. They sit down anywhere from, like I say, minimum of 15 hours to the maximum of 40 hours. I hear some crazy stories of truckers. So they're used to sitting and they're used to paying attention on the road. Great. Perfect job for programming. Let's get them a crash course, 6 months in the basics of programming, and get that workforce up. We have a shortage of real good programmers because majority of them that go to San Francisco or Israel or even now Russia. Russia's paying for a lot of them to go over, which I don't blame them. You know, you guys are getting paid, or these guys are getting paid like minimum like 120K salary plus shares, so all the power to them. But here in Canada, we need a better job force or a bigger, you know, coder job force. We need more coders over here. So this is a great opportunity for private corporations and governments to team up together and create maybe like a small 6 month crash course for these truckers. What's another industry to be disrupted? Cashiers. You know, I know a lot of people hate me on this, but I'm telling you right now, forget about hate. Forget about what you like. It's about reality. It's about what's happening today right now. Cashiers are gonna go bye-bye, see you later. So what do you do? Well, you're standing around already, you like customer service, you like helping people. There's many other jobs out there or other industries opening up. Hospitality is big. Look at other hospitality items. Or maybe this is even a great opportunity for you to say, hey, I'm not really cut out to be a cashier. I'm meant for so much more than just standing behind a desk and scanning items. I think human beings are worth so much more, and human beings can do so much more than take an item, go tick, tick, tick. You know, do you want your receipt with that? No, that's a perfect job for a robot. And instead, we got to figure out what your gift is, what your talent is. And like I said, I think it's a fiduciary responsibilities of some corporations and some municipal governments. Forget federal. I believe in more or less your municipality, your local MPs, your local area helping you out, as opposed to asking for the federal or even provincial. Okay? So it's a scary fact for a lot of people to take in that 60% of the job force will disappear within the next decade or so. But I think it's fantastic. This is evolution. There's no such thing as bad evolution or good evolution. I personally believe this is great. I believe the quality of living is increasing. People are living longer. There is less war out there. The means of communication for information is blink of a button, you know, or blink of an eye or touch of a button. It's right there. I'm on Snapchat, boom. I'm on Yahoo News, boom. I want to talk to some people in China, boom. I'm right there. So the actual transfer of knowledge and information is so rapid, it's connecting the whole world together. And the possibilities of doing business, like for example, me, 99% of my business is online. All the businesses I have is online, whether that is, you know, the membership sites I have, whether that is software I have, whether that is all these other different businesses I have, it's 100% online. That being said, this opens up possibilities. If you're looking at trends in 2017, they're predicting $2 trillion in sales in e-commerce. E-commerce alone. You know, probably SaaS. SaaS must be up there in the $10 trillion area for SaaS, so software as a service globally, both B2B and B2C. So the possibilities are here, but it's up to you to carve your future. It's up to you to push forward, to become educated. Not being educated, but become educated. Know everything. Become a connoisseur of wisdom in life. Don't sit back and pretend everything's gonna be okay. Being passive is a definition of dying a slow death. You sit back and expect your government? Well, I'm not against government. I love government. I believe we give too much power to the government, because at the end of the day, if you look at the word government, government literally means the power of the people. We give the government the power as a democratic society and as our voting dollar and our voting rights. So it's up to us as a collective, as a government, to strengthen the bonds of what's happening in society today, as opposed to being passive. Who cares? It's just politics. No, you better know your politics. You better know what's happening. You better know everything, what's going on. You know, there's that saying, if you walk in a room and if you don't know who the schmuck is, well, guess what? You are the schmuck. So get to it. Educate yourself. Learn about the trends. Learn about robotics. Learn about genomics. Learn about programming. Learn about securities. Learn about everything. Everything to do with online. And two, well, I think it was by 2020, not too long from now, 4 years, 5 years, they're saying another 1 billion people will be plugged in online. I'm doubling down my businesses in China and India and South Africa. These are emerging marketplaces around the world. You know, I'll give you an example. In Kenya, they have $100 million marketplace for buying and selling cell phone minutes. They can buy bread with cell phone minutes. They can buy bus tickets with cell phone minutes. They can buy anything. It's a currency. What is currency? Trust. Great market opportunity. In fact, if you want to study a great African who kind of revolutionized the telecom industry, study Mo Ibrahim. He sold his company, I believe to a Saudi company, but study Mo Ibrahim. He pretty much brought the telecom industry to Africa, and he's doing amazing philanthropy work right now. But once again, you know, Mo saw the trends. Mo educated himself. Mo took a risk, and Mo put everything on the line to better himself and better his fellow man in Africa. So what are you doing today to better yourself? What are you doing today to educate yourself? Now, being educated, once again, educate yourself. An educated individual is not an educated individual. Two different things, okay? So that's it. You know, I just want to quickly talk about this whole job force thing, because I believe we're gonna see some crazy disruptions in the future right now coming, and a lot of people won't be ready for it. I didn't mention VR. That's a whole different video. I'll get to VR in the next video. I believe that's an exciting industry. It's gonna be a monster industry, but there's also the dark side to that. All right, guys, I want to hear your comments and opinions about the job force, about being educated, and about bettering yourself. Leave a comment below this video. Adios.